Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make Navratan Korma. It's a very famous and traditional recipe of India. Now, the word Navratan means nine gems. In ancient times, the kings used to wear all nine gems representing all the nine planets in their hands, which would give them luck and riches, money. And the dish usually represents luck, and the name of the dish came because we are going to use nine different types of nuts and vegetables in total. So for making that, first I fried about 200 grams of paneer, just plain coated with corn flour and fried. So first you need to cut 200 grams of paneer into cubes, then fry it and keep it aside. And here in the pan I have fried about 200 grams of potatoes, also cut in cubes. Now after the potatoes are fried, take them out. The vegetables that I will use are frozen vegetables that I made. It consists of carrots, beans, peas, cauliflower. I am using fresh frozen vegetables, that's why I am not cooking it that much. I won't be cooking it that much, but if you are making it with fresh vegetables, you can definitely fry it along with the potatoes. In this, no measurement required, and we need to blanch some onions. Blanch 3 medium sized onions, 3 green chilies and 4 cloves of garlic in water for 3 to 4 minutes until the onion petals start to. After blanching for 3 to 4 minutes, take them out and put it in a blender jar. Along with three tablespoons of yogurt. And make a fine paste out of it. To that, add about a teaspoon of jeera for tempering. Along with a few garam masala. I don't have all the garam masalas right now, so I am using only cinnamon and clove. I don't have cardamom. Also add one red dry red chili. Let the masala sizzle, or the spices sizzle. Then add the onion, curd and garlic paste. On low heat, stir it continuously. Put it on low heat, otherwise the curd might split. Here I have 2 tablespoons of poppy seeds and 2 teaspoon of poppy seeds and 2 teaspoon of muskmelon seeds. Add that paste and stir. Now add salt to taste. Add about quarter teaspoon of white pepper. I don't have white pepper, so I am using black pepper. And about 1 tablespoon of sugar. This recipe is a little sweet on the sweet side, so add about 1 tablespoon of sugar. Now cook the spices. After adding the poppy seeds, poppy paste and the muskmelon paste. I am using muskmelon seeds, but you can definitely use cashew paste or any nut paste, almond paste, whatever you prefer. After adding the paste, you can turn the heat high and like medium to medium high and cook it. For the final ingredient, before all the vegetables goes in, here I have about a quarter cup of coconut paste. Now you might think this is a too lengthy recipe or with too many ingredients, but the kings used to have this. So obviously, although it's a very simple recipe, but it's a bit lengthy. But I hope if you try, you will like the taste very much. It's a very tasty recipe. Then add the vegetables and the potatoes. Now my vegetables were already cooked, that's why I didn't fry it or cook it, but if you are using fresh vegetables, definitely cook the vegetables. And at last, add the paneer. The paneer I have only fried with some corn flour. Mix everything together and let it cook for 10 minutes. Add about a cup of water and let everything boil for 10 minutes. You can add as much water as you want depending upon the thickness of the gravy that you like. I am using 1 to 1.5 cups. I will be adding half cup later, so 1 to 1.5 cup water. Let it cook for 10 minutes and your dish will be ready. Always check the seasoning if it requires anything more or less. Mine needs a little bit of sugar, so I am adding 1/2 teaspoon of sugar more. My salt was perfect and the spiciness was also perfect. Now let it cover and let it cook for 5 to 10 minutes and the dish will be ready.